Welcome to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. In this video, we will talk about regulation of cardiac output. Cardiac output is a net quantity of blood pumped out by the heart each minute. It's equal to stroke volume times heart rate. Under normal resting condition, it's about 5 liters per minute. But depending on the body's requirement, it can be adjusted. So, how this adjustment is done? The simple answer is by regulating venous return. Venous return is the most important parameter determining cardiac output. The factors affecting venous return in turn are venous pressure, sympathetic activity, venous valves, muscle pump, respiratory pump, and cardiac suction effect. We have already studied these factors in detail in a video on venous return, so we won't repeat that detail here. Here we will focus on how venous return affects cardiac output. There are three mechanisms behind this: Frank-Starling mechanism, direct stretching of SA node, and Bainbridge reflex. First, let's see the Frank-Starling mechanism. See, increase in venous return increases the end diastolic volume. Or in simple words, when more blood returns to the heart, the wall of the ventricles gets more stretched. Now, we have already studied in the video on length-tension relationship that within physiological limits, the more the initial stretching of the muscle, the more tension it can develop. This is because with increasing initial length, the actin and myosin take more optimal position to interact with each other. So, number of cross-bridge interaction increases, which results in increased force of contraction. In short, increase in venous return increases the stretching of the myocardium. So, the force of contraction increases, which increases the stroke volume. So, cardiac output is increased. This is called the Frank-Starling mechanism of the heart. Second mechanism is direct stretching of the SA node. See, the SA node is located in the wall of the right atrium. So, when increased venous return stretches the atrial wall, the SA node is also stretched simultaneously. This stretching itself increases the activity of SA node by intrinsic mechanism. So, the heart rate increases, which increases cardiac output. So, this is how direct stretching of SA node increases cardiac output. And finally, we have Bainbridge reflex. This is also initiated by stretching of the atrial wall. The atrial wall has low pressure baroreceptors. Increase in venous return or blood volume increases the stretching of the atrial wall. This activates these receptors. Through vagus nerve, these signals go to the cardiovascular control centers in the medulla. They in turn increase the sympathetic stimulation of the SA node. There is a decrease in parasympathetic activity also. This causes increase in heart rate, which in turn contributes to increase in cardiac output. So, this is how cardiac output is controlled indirectly by venous return. Apart from this, it is also regulated by direct sympathetic or parasympathetic activity. These influences are mostly a part of blood pressure regulation mechanisms, like sympathetic tone, baroreceptor or chemoreceptor reflex, response to a change in blood volume, control by higher centers in the brain, CNS ischemic response, Cushing reaction, etc. These mechanisms are also already explained in detail in the video on regulation of blood pressure, so we won't repeat them either. So, this was all about regulation of cardiac output. Now, let's have a quick summary. Main factor controlling cardiac output is venous return. The increasing venous return increases the cardiac output by Frank-Starling mechanism, direct stretching of SA node, and Bainbridge reflex. Cardiac output is one of the important determinants of blood pressure. So, it's also regulated as part of blood pressure regulation mechanisms. That's it for control of cardiac output. For sticking with me until the end, here is an interesting bonus point for you. We have baroreceptors that can sense blood pressure and blood volume, and chemoreceptors that can sense concentration of oxygen, carbon dioxide, etc. in the blood. but we don't have any sensor that measures cardiac output. So fundamentally, what body is actually trying to correct is these parameters. But the cardiac output is an indirect determinant of these parameters. So it's affected indirectly as the body tries to correct them. That's it for this video. Please hit all YouTube buttons that you see below this video. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.